All right, this problem asks us to take a look at this diagram and decide whether or not it represents a physical change or a chemical change. Remember that a physical change is a process where the identity of the substance does not change, and a chemical process is where the identity of the substance does change. And so what are we looking at here? We're looking at a collection of red particles and a collection of black particles. In the process, the collection of black particles and red particles become evenly distributed and mixed around. But at the end of the day, what we have here on the left-hand side is still essentially a collection of black particles. And now you still have black particles here at the end of the process, but they're interspersed with some red particles. Now, the same thing can be said to be true with the red particles. You have a collection of red particles, and at the end of the day, you have a collection of red particles that are interspersed with some black particles. So what does this entail? Does it entail a physical change or a chemical change? Well, you go from red particles and black particles to red particles and black particles that are just mixed up. And that is indicative of a physical change. The identity of the particles being just solitary black particles and solitary red particles, they don't change. So since the identity doesn't change in the process, it's physical. Okay.